Welcome students, I am Nafisa, your social science teacher. Today in this video we will cover the topic mineral based industries. Before we start mineral based industries and under that let us discuss iron and steel industry in detail. Let us recapitulate the points we have discussed till now. We have started this lesson with the definition of manufacturing industries, followed by location of industry and then classification of industry. In the previous videos we have discussed clearly about agro-based industries. Under that we have covered textile industry. Under textile industries, cotton textile, jute textile and sugar industry, and we have discussed of the map pointing also in detail. So today, as we have completed agro-based industries, we are starting the topic mineral based industries. Let's discuss this topic in detail. Industries which use minerals and metals as raw material are called as mineral based industries. Can you name some of the industries that fall under this category? Like iron and steel industry, aluminium smelting, then chemical industry, fertilizer industry, cement industry, automobiles, all these are referred to mineral based industry. Iron and steel industry is referred to as basic industry, and it is one of the important question in the lesson. Also you might be asked a question, what is a basic industry, or which industry is referred to as basic industry, what are the challenges faced by the industry, or what is the role of this basic industry in the Indian economy. So basic industry in the sense you need to mention as iron and steel industry. Why do we call it as basic industry? Reason, other industries, whether it is heavy, medium or light, any type of industry, they are dependent on iron and steel industry. Reason, machinery. Any industry machine is required, and all those machines basic at the base level is iron and steel industry. Steel is needed to manufacture a variety of engineering goods, construction material, defense, medical, telephone, scientific equipments, along with consumer goods. So iron and steel industry referred to as basic industry because base of iron sheets are provided by this industry. Automobile industry, for the purpose of construction, used in defense, for making scientific equipment, for making basic molds, small molds or bolts and nuts, utensils which we use in our homes, surgical equipment. These are all just a few examples where we use steel. Just you look, if you look at your home surroundings, you can find lot many items where steel is being used. So that's your next question also. List of goods which are made of production and consumption of steel is often recorded as the index of country's development. Iron and steel is a heavy industry. So you may get a question, what is regarded as index of country's development? It is iron and steel industry, because the more of iron and steel we use in or we consume, in the sense, the more developed country we are. Iron and steel is a heavy industry. We all know reason, raw material is very heavy, iron ore, the bulky raw materials. At the same time, after finishing also, even finished goods also heavy and bulky. So transportation cost is more, because raw material when the item gets in the factory or moves out of the factory, the material is very heavy. Now let's have a look at the process, how this steel is been made. In order to make a steel, what is the equation? So we have to use iron ore, coking coal and limestone. Coking coal is not the normal coal which we see. Coking coal is of same like coal itself, but it's of high variety, high gradient, which has high capacity to burn. Okay, so it is been used in the ratio of 4:2:1, and at some quantity manganese also is been added to this, and manganese is added to harden the steel. It can be asked for 1 mark question, what is the equation? Then you have to write 4:2:1, 4 parts of iron ore, 2 parts of coking coal and 1 part of limestone is been used. I will show you the, through the picture also. At the same time, manganese is also added to harden the steel. Okay, first let's have a look at the process, how the steel is made. Have a look at the percentage. Okay, iron ore 4%, कोकिंग कोल 2% मीन्स वेन आयरन ओर इज ऑफ 4 times कोकिंग कोल एंड लाइम 4:2:1 रेशियो इज बीन यूज फॉर मेकिंग द दिस इज अ पिक्चर हाउ मैंगनीज ओर लुक लाइक इट इज एडेड टू स्ट्रेंथन द हार्ड एंड द स्टील. Now let's have a look. This is known as blasting furnace. So what is done? Iron ore, coking coal and limestone both are added into this furnace and it's been melted at 1800 degrees Celsius. At the top it is a 400, by the time it comes down 1800. This is the place for the hot gases to leave, and then molten stage, then when this iron melts, then it comes out through this into a mould known as pig iron. Here you can have a look at the simplified version of this like ore, coke, limestone has been added here, blast furnace has been added into blast furnace, and it is used for smelting hot air. This place is for the hot air to go out, and whatever raw particles are there, they'll move, slag, unnecessary matter moves out there, and then the molten metal from here it's been poured. The same process is been explained through the flowchart in your textbook. What is this? First raw material is transported to a steel plant. There they'll use the blast furnace, just now we have seen it. In that they'll mix iron ore, limestone, okay, and then coking coal is been added, slag is removed, and then the molten one is being poured into a pigs or molds known as pig iron. Okay, then after that pig iron, from the pig iron they'll make the steel, and the different shapes like rolling, pressing, casting, forging are been done, and the steel is been made. Then finally steel of this type is been produced. Hope you have understood about the process of manufacturing steel. Now comes another important question, like where should these steel plants ideally be located? Where the steel plant should be located? Just now we have discussed it, no? This raw material and finished product both are heavy. So ideally it should be located near the places where the raw material is formed, at the same time where it's possible for them to distribute to markets and consumers, where they can find easy network, efficient transport system is available. So those places it's feasible for them, because transportation plays a major role for iron and steel industry. In 2016, 95.6 million tons of crude steel production. Just now has shown you the big molds of iron sheets. Okay, the steel production is being produced in India, and India is ranked third among the world crude steel producers. Okay, India's place is third place after China and Japan. Whereas when it comes to sponge iron, India is the largest producer. India's position is number one. Now let us see what is this sponge iron. Okay, the sponge iron looks like this. So it is a form of iron that we can produce directly from iron ore through the reduction process. Okay, whereas pig iron, just now before process I have shown you in blast furnace, pig iron is a form of iron that we produce by melting iron ore along with charcoal and limestone under very high pressure, whereas this has been produced only by melting raw iron ore. So India is the leading producer of sponge iron, and when it comes to consumption of steel also, India's consumption level is very less. It is only 63 kgs per annum, whereas overall world average is 208 kgs. And you can have a look at the flowchart also here, means this table, where 2010 and 11 it's 68.62, whereas 16 and 11 101.3 production of steel in India. Okay, now comes the question, why is the per capita consumption of steel is so low in India? Just now we have seen India's consumption level is very low. Why is it so low? Reasons: high cost and limited availability of coking coal. That's the reason we are leading exporter of sponge iron. If you take the condition of cotton also, we are exporting cotton rather than the finished product, and we all know that final product has more value than the raw material. We know it, but due to the lack of facilities, even same condition even for iron also. We are the largest producer of sponge iron. Sponge iron, just now I have shown you, it is the raw form of melting it only the iron without coking coal, because the availability of coking coal in India is less. High cost, limited availability of coking coal, low productivity of labor, disrupted supply of electricity, these are all the reasons so that the consumption of steel is so low in India. Now this activity, can you do it? Collect information about steel plants in India. So you are collecting the information and you are giving it during the time of discussion. Now let's discuss about two types of plants. One is mini steel plant, another one is integrated steel plant. As the names itself suggest, mini steel plant in the sense where the equipment is used at a lower phase, like smaller, and they use electric furnaces, and they use steel scrap and sponge iron. Okay, now let's understand what is meant by mini steel plant and integrated steel plant. As the name itself suggests, mini steel plant in the sense the plants which produces steel at a lower level, means with minimum consumption, minimum facilities, like they are smaller and they use electric furnaces and they use steel scrap and sponge iron. They have re-rollers that use steel lingots as well. They produce mild and alloy steel given under specifications. Whereas integrated steel plant is large and they handle everything in one complex, like from putting raw material to steel making, rolling and shaping, everything is done using the big equipment, large infrastructure. Let's try to understand the difference between mini steel plant and integrated steel plants to this flowchart. Like as you can see, integrated steel plants, they are using big blast furnace, okay, iron ore, coking coal, limestone, everything is used here, okay. Whereas when it comes to mini steel plants, they are using electric furnaces, okay, at the same time only iron ore and coal to a minimum level they have been using. And you can see the big equipment here, ladle, and then it's been processed and it's been sent into a pig. It becomes pig iron is been produced. Okay, now let's look public sector undertaking. Most of the public sector undertakings, I mean under the government control, market their steel through SAIL, S-A-I-L, SAIL, full form is Steel Authority of India. Whereas the private under private sector, TISCO is leading in steel manufacturing. TISCO in the sense Tata Iron and Steel Industry. Okay, now let's have a look at the condition here. 1950s, during the year 1950s, China and India produced steel of same quantity. China and India are on the same path in the production of steel. But today, if you look at the condition of today, China is the largest producer and consumer of steel. Okay, what are the reasons? Let us discuss during challenges to iron and steel industries. We'll discuss in detail. So now comes, where can we find this iron and iron mines? Chota Nagpur Plateau region has the maximum concentration of iron and steel industry region. This is the place where we can find mines also. So let's have a look at iron and steel industries in India. You can find iron and steel industries, let us come from south, in Tamil Nadu, in Salem, whereas Karnataka two places, Bhadravati and Vijayanagar. Whereas majority of the iron and steel we can find near this Chota Nagpur region. Okay. Remember Chota Nagpur region we have studied, Chota Nagpur Plateau and Malwa Plateau, this area refers to as Chota Nagpur Plateau, which consists of Orissa, Jharkhand and Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh and West Bengal regions. Okay, and you can find, these are the iron and steel industries like Bokaro, Jamshedpur, Rourkela, Bhilai, Durgapur and Burnpur. We can find lot many iron and steel industries here. Reason, lot many iron ores also available here, mines. And as we have discussed, heavy bulky material during the time of raw material getting and transportation of finished product is bit bulky material. So if you check these areas near to the market, at the same time good transportation facility near to the seaport also, yes, and good transport facilities, and these are the places where we can find more population. Density of population is more, so availability of labor also more. So nearness to the market, then nearness to the raw material site, good transport facilities and cheap labor, availability of cheap labor, all these have made concentration of many iron and steel industries in the Chota Nagpur region. So here comes your question also, why many iron and steel industries are located in Chota Nagpur region? The reason is many advantages are available in this region. What are those advantages? Low cost of iron ore because it's available nearby. Then high grade raw materials in proximity means nearby lot of raw material is available. Then cheap labor, and then vast growth of potential in home market. So these are all the reasons for the concentration of iron and steel industries in Chota Nagpur Plateau. Though India is an important iron and steel producing country in the world, yet we are unable to perform to our full potential. As we have seen, 1950, India and China both are on the same stage. Now China is the leading producer, India didn't reach the position. Why? What are the reasons? So here comes the reasons or challenges. We can call it as challenges to iron and steel industries. First one, high cost and limited availability of coking coal. Second one, lower productivity of labor. Third one, irregular supply of energy. Then poor infrastructure. Because of these reasons, iron in the raw form, like sponge iron, we are leading producer, leading exporter of sponge iron, but not the steel. We also import good quality steel from other countries, but whatever steel we are producing in India, it is sufficient for us to meet the domestic demands. And other now, due to this liberalization and foreign direct investment, now the iron and steel industry slowly booming with the efforts of the private entrepreneurs. Like TISCO is the leading one, I said, Tata Iron and Steel Industry, leading producer, and lot many MNCs of Tata are there in the world. About MNCs, liberalization, globalization, we'll discuss in economics lesson in detail. But even then, still we have to allocate resources for research and development of how to produce steel more competitively, effectively, so that we can use the available resources in an effective way. With this, we have completed iron and steel industry under mineral industries. Now here comes a question activity. Let us discuss this question during our discussion time. So it's about Kalinganagar controversy. Gather the information. Let us discuss this. Hope you have understood about iron and steel industry. Still, if you have any doubts, we can clear it up during the time of our discussion. Thank you.